Follow me on a journey where no one has ever been before. Listen to the Cali Effect.
Good evening, YouTube. You guys are now watching another segment of the Cali Effect. Today, we're going to be doing file number 3 in Dual Terminal. Now, I know, unlike Dual Terminal 1 and file number 1 and 2, this one actually isn't about the Dual Terminal story. It's about the legendary Six Samurai, so it'll be an interesting lead. The samurai declared to be the strongest in the land divided by a civil war. Those who assisted Sheen in the past each now hold an important post. However, in their younger years, they stood in the battlefield with Sheen as the legendary Six Samurai, who were the predecessors of the Six Samurai. Those were talented, powerful elite who stood alone in the battlefields of the warm, torn country amidst the civil war. Okay, so the legendary Six Samurais, or the previous versions, the predecessors of the now Six Samurai. I wonder, would this actually help us show who are the legendary Six as opposed to the regular Six? Okay, so those are a couple of the legendary Six Samurai. And if you guys did not know, these are the Six Samurai. So the legendary Six Samurai are the samurais of the past, if you guys did not know. And these Six Samurai are, I don't want to say necessarily futuristic samurais, but they are definitely the samurais into the future. As I did not know, this is actually Sheen's castle, and that's where, you know, they post out at, you know, 420 Yellow Swag Blaze It. They're normally here posting in this area. So, I mean, I thought that would be pretty cool. Sheen charged across the battlefield as the central figure in the Six Samurai, with many severed heads lying in the wake at every battle. We're still talking about Yu-Gi-Oh, right? Like, that's a little bit much for Yu-Gi-Oh. The young warrior climbed his way up with the inborn craftiness and cunning wisdom, as it didn't take much for his name to be carved into the area of civil war. Okay, so this young leader has taken countless people's names and killed a lot of people. So, I mean, I thought that was pretty descriptive. Full of ambition, those who look upon him wither and shrink before him. It is said that his crimson armor is dyed that color from the blood spurting from every enemy commander he cuts down, and flickers of the fires that rage around him, so it becomes even redder as time goes on. So we see his armor getting darker, I guess. No, actually, I think this is right here. So this man has some pretty red armor, and it has flames around him, so he's killed quite a few people, you know, with the crimson red and the flames around them. I see you. You an ice cold killer. All right. The man eventually calls himself Sheen instead of Shaeen. Unlike Kizan and the Nishi, he does not age alongside his friends. In fact, he remains so young, a sign that he is a demon king. Possibly. Okay, so this is him with his battle suit armor behind him, if it ever loads. Yeah, this is him with his battle suit armor behind him. Red eyes. Okay, so I think he is a demon king. All right, that makes sense. This is him being attacked by one of the ninja monsters. I don't know exactly what happens there, but it doesn't look too well for the ninja monster, seeing that in this picture, he's still alive. So, yeah, I don't really know what else to say. And that red eyes are really getting to me. Like, maybe he is a demon samurai monster, which, I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of cool. And then this is him without the full armor on his horse with the red eyes. So, yeah, he does not age, unlike, you know, his friends. So that's kind of weird. One of the warriors of the invincible legendary Six Samurai, with his keen eye and elegant swordsmanship, has rescued Sheen from many disasters. Nowadays, he is the Grand Master who guides the current samurai. Alright, so Grand Master, or Kizan, is now Grand Master of the Six Samurai? Alright, so that makes perfect sense. His stats are relatively the same thing, and as you guys can see, he did age, unlike the other, you know, unlike Sheen, you know, from black hair to gray hair. The skill of Kizan shows a sense of clarity and the skill amongst fierce, brutal fights, and it is rumored that when someone notices they've been slain by him, this soul is slain alongside him. This man's strong to the point that the rank in the file of enemy armies cover and tremble if they have to fight the legendary Six Samurai. All right, so I'm assuming that he's the one that sets the tone. You get killed by him, your soul goes along with it. He's probably one of the fiercest behind Shin. So, yeah, they normally see him and they tremble. Oh, legendary Six Samurai. There was a rivalry for merit, even within the legendary Six Samurai, as Kizan constantly spars with his friendly rival, Inishi. Kizan showing off his power before Shin becomes the Grandmaster of the Six Samurai. Alright, so the top three samurais, as we can see, is Shin is the head, he's the head honcho. Then it would go Kizan, because Kizan is the samurai, the Grandmaster. And then Inishi as his sparring partner and rival. Those three are the strongest Six Samurai. Now, that's Kizan in the present, as I've already shown. You guys, Kizan in the present, which is Grandmaster of the Six Samurai. This is Legendary Six Samurai Inishi, his sparring partner. Inishi, who is mocked for his recklessness, is known as the Daredevil. Since he knew Shin when they were a part of the Legendary Six Samurai, he is not intimidated by him. So by offering his opinions and viewpoints, he ended becoming the Chancellor who supports Shin. Oh, alright. So, Inishi's not scared of Shin, since he knew Shin where they were a part of the Legendary Six Samurai, alright, and he's not really intimidated by him. He offers his own opinion, and he ended becoming the Chancellor who supports Shin, alright, so that makes sense. This is Inishi Shin's Chancellor, alright. This is when he was once a Chancellor, that doesn't make sense, because in the past tense, when he was a Legendary Six Samurai, maybe he just became the Chancellor. Alright, never mind. So, he was once the guy who stood up to Shin, or he was reckless, and now he became the Chancellor. It makes perfect sense. Now, Legendary Six Samurai Kageki. With mechanical arms installed in the back for support, Kageki was feared as the four-armed Onigami. But he lost both his arms in the midst of the battle. He had two artificial arms installed and was given the job to protect the great Shogun Shin as the Chamberlain after leaving the front lines. Alright, so he became the Chamberlain after the battle because, I mean, he obviously wasn't as strong anymore, losing both his arms. Shinai. The samurai who was most trusted by Shin was a heroic warrior who could escape from the jaws of death no matter what. However, after sadly dying in later years of a great war, his soul ended up dwelling inside the armor he died in, and now protects the current generation of the Six Samurai. Alright. So, Shinai becomes Spirit of the Six Samurai. Alright, if you guys aren't catching on, Kizan becomes Grandmaster, Inishi becomes Inishi, obviously. Kageki becomes Chamberlain, Shinai becomes the Spirit. Alright, Shinai used to escape from every battle, kind of like, what's his name off of Gears of War? I can't remember his name. And then one day he just dies, but in this time he comes back. Mizuhu of the Six Samurai. The lone woman of the Legendary Six Samurai who was joined to Shinai as husband and wife. Alright, so they were both married. After Shinai died, she joined a religious order, but her skills have not changed since the day she was on active duty, as even now she serves as the hand of Shin. Made flesh, striking down those who would warn him. So she's, I guess, like the religious lady, the preacher, the doctor, or however, the pope. I don't know what to tell you, but she is used to be a warrior, and now she's not necessarily that warrior anymore, but she still knows how to do her craft. Those who serve Shin. Skilled and able followers who serve Shin, who turn to discover their skills, even if they were but a mere soldier, he would appoint those with true talent to a post more benefiting their talents and such. A great number of people desired to serve both samurais and bureaucrat under Shin, simply because of the ease of judging one's character. Shin was able to march down the otherwise inaccessible road and lead them to seizing the whole nation. All right, so the samurai seized the whole nation. A rank and file soldier, he is treated as a pawn in the battlefield. They sincerely have great faith in Master Shin. Alright, so all the squires have great faith in Shin. Kagemusha of the Six Samurai as the Kagemusha of the Six Samurai. It is said he can copy them entirely down to their voice and mannerisms. Alright, sweet. Shin's advisor, an advisor who supports the legendary Six Samurai from the shadows. He takes terrain and the difference in military power into account as he calmly analyzes the situation. And then the elder of the Six Samurai, Shin's advisor after he retired. While he's retired from serving from the front line, he enjoys watching the pupil Anishi work. Alright, sweet. So, we have basically everything about the Six Samurais. They all serve under Great Shogun Shin or Tenkai, whatever Shin, however you guys want to say it. And that's basically how, for the most part, the Six Samurais work. Kind of a little, I'm a little disappointed that, you know, they didn't go into the other Six Samurais like Yachi and Kaigeki, but those are actually the futuristic Six Samurais, while these are the legendary Six Samurais and how they came about. But that's basically how Six Samurais or the legendary Six Samurais work. That being said, thank you guys for watching the segment of Cali Effect. Please like, comment, subscribe, but most of all, enjoy.